Half a sheep covering.
The arts of the Etheria. The Etheria.
Please join us as we visit Windsor to the west of Sydney, still in the Sydney Basin, just at the foot of the Blue Mountains. Quite an old historic town. So we will visit Windsor in part one and then Richmond in part two. This is Windsor in Sydney, and there's a small park right here, and you have the three gateways going through with Juchan and Boaz, the pillars right here. So we'll go through, proceed through. Just before we proceed through, we'll just notice that you have the classic swirl coming down, but the swirl would relate to etheric matter, kind of if pouring down, if you will, around the sides of what's going on here. So some old artillery here, and then we're walking through and we have the magic circle in the center here. Now before we proceed further, we'll just look at the Sydney Masonic Center, and inside you have the two pillars of Juchan and Boaz, and you have the circle there in light and made up with the lights sort of just inside the pillars of Juchan and Boaz, if you will. Now, we've kind of got a bit of a circle around here with the trees, a magic circle in a way, and of course the participant would be a tree also. You would have the kind of chakras running through and all the rest of it. But I've sort of gone through this many times. So we would have the obelisk, and the obelisk would perhaps be an obelisk of light right here in the center, along with much of this, which is kind of cast in stone. So this memorial is quite old. This refers to the Second Boer War in South Africa, and you can see the dates, respective dates on there. So it's an old monument with the three steps right there and that light obelisk, I would suggest, in the center. Now you have, of course, in those days, as far as military exercises were going, the horse would have played a very large part. And there's the horse right there. It's in the alcove. If we go around the side, you'll see the structure of the alcove in there also, and of course that would be on the four sides of this monument right here. You have the four rivers, the four pathways coming out, as you would see time and time again with various monuments, and this sort of thing would relate to the pyramids in Egypt also. Now we'll just come over this way, and this is a bit of a very amateur demonstration of the divining.
Shoes off, I was told.
What do you call it? Wait a minute, what are we doing? This is divining.
This is dowsing.
Dowsing, sorry, I'm not even thinking. Yeah, it is called divining as well.
That's water divining.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
the same thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is the same thing.
Yeah,
yeah.
Or sort of. Okay. So here's a demonstration, and we have the two L rods right here, and we'll just proceed forward and see if anything happens. And if anything happens, I don't know if we're going to suggest that it means this or that, but so just around the monument here. A little bit of dowsing. So I'd just like to take a moment to mention that, yeah, sure, this is extremely amateurish, this dowsing that we're doing right now, but at least we're out there having a go. From what I could see, there was nothing conclusive. Years ago, I met an occultist who claimed that he doused in a particular installation within one of our parks here in Sydney. I don't want to mention that particular monument because the occult, because it really gives away who that person is, and that was a person who probably said a few things that he shouldn't have in my company as we went out for coffee and all sorts of bits and pieces. And in fact, that person was looking to recruit me for magic rituals. But besides that, he got angry, this person got angry at the notion of the likes of me letting the public know about the occult. He got quite angry about it, but at the same time, he liked to speak to me and we got on quite well. But anyway, so get out there, people, do stuff, try and meet people, try and use the information that I have in my videos. Really, just be confident and talk to the likes of Freemasons and people within other secretive societies. How are you going to meet them? I don't know. Try to find esoteric libraries and that sort of thing within your city. If you're in the country and that sort of thing, you're going to struggle. But anyway, and while I'm on a bit of a rant, I'll just also mention that yet another magic practicing Mason, and now going into this Mason's house, there were books on the wall, just magic and cards out and all the rest of it right there. Really into it. Now, the reason for having those cards out is that you are surrounding yourself with magical symbols also, and that is also part of it. And that brings, it's an interesting aspect because you see the symbols on buildings and all that sort of thing also, and in logos and all these sorts of things, and I have my own theories about that. But this Mason was also talking about not only bringing me into a particular private magic ritual, another one, and this was for a particular reason that I won't go into, but also me being part of a seance. Now, when I say in practice, I haven't practiced magic myself after all these years of doing this, so in a way, I'm a bit of a hypocrite there, but I'm also very wary of it and quite protective. Just for a moment here, let's reference the Bible for a moment. Now, within this verse, you can see reference to an armor of light. Now, an armor is something that goes on the exterior of your body, and this should be, well, for me, it's pretty obvious, but for so-called Christians, they just don't get it. I don't think I've ever met a Christian, but anyway. So in this verse, you can see reference to the armor of God. And indeed, once again, it tells you that it's not a wrestle or a fight against flesh and blood, against the physical, in other words. And, you know, within the artwork, within churches and stuff, they show the light body. In a way, I'm a bit of a hypocrite there, but I'm also very wary of it and are quite protective. In my video, I had Laszlo with that experience.
Oh, guys, I feel I feel numb my leg, and I get it. And it's been off needles in my leg. It's coming into me, yeah, feel like it. Anybody can hold the camera, please.
You have a situation, guys, with somebody up and out. This happened the last time. Over here, we're over here. Hang on, I'll grab a torch.
I'm a bit of a hypocrite there, but I'm also very wary of it and are quite protective. In my video, I had Laszlo with that experience, and he no longer sort of goes out on those ghost hunting experiences where the ghost seemingly went into him and it has affected him and all the rest of it. But anyway, let's carry on with this video. Okay, everyone, this is Windsor in Sydney, and we'll probably get over and have a little look at that church and the grounds over there, but just for a moment, we have the park here panning around, and we have a monument here to both Elizabeth and Lachlan Macquarie with the kind of wedge shape going in here, and the little plaque right here, and then the mage in the centre, in this case Lachlan Macquarie. And the interesting thing here that I picked up sort of straight away is you have on one side you have the female, and then coming around the other you have the male. So the male and female energies represented in the center here, I would certainly suggest. So you have the dodeca, the 12 sides here, dodecagonal configuration here. Now, just for a moment, there is a rotunda over here, and then the obelisk is right through there. Now, evidently, the rotunda and the obelisk line up with the cenotaph in Hyde Park in Sydney. So just drawing a line over that right now and checking that out. That's an alignment found by Jeff of the YouTube site Jeff Lewis. So just pointing that one out as we have a look around here.
Just looking at some of the artwork around here, the rivers, you'll see the river coming out here, and that is perhaps a reference to the four rivers that sort of come out of the tree of life in a way, the central, what would be the mage in the center, the etheric pillar in the center right here. Just another thing I'll point out here, just for a bit of reference, is the pictures here of Lachlan and Elizabeth right there. The church. So we're in the grounds of this church here at Windsor, and you have this Masonic tomb here, and you would have the four grails around here, so the four around the participant in the center in a way, but this is a grave. So I'll just quickly just show, and I've shown this many times before, but you have the sort of structure here with the ring and the foliage coming through. Interesting cross configuration here, the sort of tree of life cross, if you will, in a way. And among other aspects here, I'd like to point out another example of the structure atop this pedestal here, the actual, what I would suggest is a light structure going up to the ring and then the foliage pouring through as a representation of a light structure, again, strangely enough. So we'll go into this church here. Now this church would be, there you can see the four grails up there around the internal octagonal structure in this case. This end of the church would face eastward towards the rising sun, and this would be the end of the church here. And we will notice that you have the round structure here. So we will go inside because the door appeared to be open, so hopefully we can film inside, and we'll see if there's any gold here, alchemical gold, at what would be the crown chakra of the church. Interesting, you can see the rope configuration right up there. Within the cemetery here on this tomb, we have the cross in here with the veil. Really interesting to see the light, to see the veil, and this would suggest that the actual cross is a cross not of this physical realm, I would suggest, with the veil right there, the veil of light, and the light cross in the center. Now, in front of, around beside the church here, and in a way off the street here, we have what is, I would suggest, a magic circle with the grails around, and a rather lush internal structure here, a light structure, again with the structure and the foliage. So we have the little places along the street here in the wall for the ashes, the remains of the dead, well, the dead of within this realm anyway. And indeed we have a continuation of that around here, so in a way sort of participants in a circle in a way also. So within there you would have the central pillar, central column, with the four columns around it also.
I'm gonna go into the church after that, I'll meet you in there or whatever. I'm just gonna go over here.
So just wanted to point this grave out here. Just notably you have the four orbs here, and I've sort of talked about this time and time again, and they've gone to the trouble here on this grave to have the directions here, so north, they don't point in the right direction, and we would have west right there with the W, and they do that on what are these globes, and the center of it is, it's a sort of a hollowed inside, but it's an underground tomb. So I just thought I'd show this. We'll just have a quick look at this one over here with this sort of tree configuration, and then we'll head into the church. So here is this tree in the center here, the center participant, the tree, and as I've shown in a couple of places, you have the seven orbs on the tree, which I would suggest the seven chakras. So this is in a way the mage standing in the center. And so there it is up there, with various symbology here, the swirls there, the etheric swirls, amidst other aspects, and the grails around the outside, and the shell, and so forth. this looks like a kind of, in a way, perhaps an etheric portal-ish looking thing in a way here. But this is the church over here once again. I talk about the person as a tree, and here you can see the foliage, the tree-like foliage with the hand emerging from it in this case. Here is the foundation stone to the church laid by Lachlan Macquarie on the 11th of October in 1817. Lachlan Macquarie was a Freemason. Now, actually, this church, I'll correct myself, faces towards the more southerly direction in this case, and you have the classic red doors featured here. But we will enter the church around here. Okay, so we are inside St. Matthew's Anglican Church here in Windsor, and this is an old Bible right here with other things in here. So we'll just take a bit of a walk up and through. There's some pews. I don't know how well or how long they've lasted in here, but of note in this case, right in the center of the church is the font right here. And interestingly, down here with these little aspects here, you can see those, they are very altar-esque. So we have the configuration, and you can see the old stone floor here, the what would be the original stone floor in here, but the altar in the center right here. The stained glass windows to this more northerly direction of the church are very lush, and we have the eagle here, as you will often find, and on the pillar of light with the lion's paws emerging from that pillar. Also an interdimensional theme carried through. This would be the end of the church, the temple. The nave would be more this aspect of the church up here. So the human body kind of laid out in a way within churches. And we have the checkered floor up here. There is a gold aspect to this, as you can see, with the sort of alcoves here and the gold aspect that you can see here. The three steps with the cross there, the Masonic three steps. And in this case, there is a feature of the stars up here. So just a bit of a look through this church.
Just focusing on another church for a moment, the St. James's Church in Sydney, you have the alchemical gold there. It was an occultist who pointed me to this.
Looking through, and we have a layout just here, and if I so it's got a bit of a layout of the whole church here with the what I would suggest is the magic circle configuration outside, and the church here with the sanctuary, the sort of crown chakra, if you will, right there that we just saw. The nave would be right here, and the kind of genitalia, the region around here. You'd have the red doors, the Vesica Pisces, that sort of thing there.
I hope you've enjoyed this visit to Windsor. In the next part, we will visit Richmond, where there will be, within one of the pergolas there, quite a very interesting installation.